Veteran photojournalist and filmmaker Shaul Schwarz directed this documentary, which opens today in New York and Los Angeles. And Shaul is joining me now live from CNN New York. Thank you so much for joining us. Shaul, tell us about the two men you featured in your film. Why did you choose them?
Well, I wanted to show a different side of the drug war. A lot has been talked about the violence, and I think it's very important, but the show you just played all happens in El Paso. Imagine these words are being sung literally a mile from the border. And I think it's time to look at not only who gets killed in the drug war, but how it spills over into our hearts and mind. How deep does this go? How far will it go? How long will we keep doing the same failed policies to not change the reality?
When you were filming this in Mexico, what were people saying about the drug war? There's a very moving scene in which a mother who's just lost her son in this drug war curses the former president Calderon, saying, why go ahead with this drug war?
Well, you know, the interesting thing is it's not often that people get to speak out of the intimidation and fear that the cartels have installed in people. And Juarez, if you speak out like that woman did, you usually could be hurt. And that woman was speaking out of grief of having her son literally chopped up. Interestingly enough, after that scene was filmed, she disappeared. She had to leave town in a hurry out of fret. So it's a very uncommon thing, and it's a very sad reality that they've installed in this town.
And given this brutal, sad reality, what is the appeal of these songs? Oh, we are bloodthirsty, crazy, and we love to kill, and you see people just singing along and really having a good time.
Yeah, it's shocking. It was shocking to me when I first saw it. But I think if we want to start to understand how people get this, we have to look at the policies. We have to understand that narco corridos have been around for a while, and since 2006, there's been a huge increase in murder rates, and we've drummed up this war that haven't been able to bring any of the kingpins to justice. And when the youth, particularly the Latino youth on both sides of the border, when they see this, they start mimicking a different reality. They see a trend that's rising, and they want to be part of that. This is, if you will, their way to connect to heritage of what's happening in Mexico.
You're talking about the appeal in the United States, which to me was shocking to see the appeal it has in the United States. Is it mostly among the Latino community?
Yes, it is. It is mostly among the Latino community, but keep in mind, this is hundreds or thousands of clubs each weekend around the country that cater to this kind of music. It is a music scene, and it's one I think that Latinos feel at home with in terms of this bad boy music. Before you would argue that they would go to hip hop or rap to see this kind of scene, which where they don't fit in. And here, this has a growing appeal to them, and it's catching fire.
What can you tell us about the character of the CSI investigator? Is he still alive after being in your movie?
Yes, he is. Richie's still alive. He works, he continues to work in the CSI unit. When I covered the CSI unit in Juarez, it was the busiest CSI unit in the world. And what I found fascinating is they do their job very meticulously. They collect the evidence, they go to murder after murder, pick up body after body. So at times, there was a day of 20 murders that I was there. But eventually, what's shocking is less than 3% of those files ever get open to get looked at. So if you will, this is another act of people pretending to do something when the reality just continues to roll on and be as horrific as it has become in Ciudad Juarez.
Certainly a disturbing and very interesting look at the drug culture and its seeping into popular culture. Shaul Schwarz, thank you so much for speaking with us.
Thank you for having me.